Hello everybody, this is Freshkey33 here, and this is my first episode of Team Analysis. I hope you like this video, and I would love you guys to like it and give me any suggestions for what I should improve on next time. Today we have a very cool team that I made. It consists of Raichu, Pineco, Hypno, Beartick, Tauros, and Clamperl. I'm going to start out with Raichu because Raichu is the lead and kind of scout of the team. It is a max special attack, modest nature, and max speed Raichu. The ability is Lightning Rod to absorb any stray electric attacks, which can be helpful when trying to absorb the attack aimed at Clamperl. But the moves are Thunderbolt, Hidden Power Ice, Grass Knot, and Volt Switch. And the reason I picked these three is four because they have very good type coverage, and plus a Volt Switch is very helpful if they don't have a ground. But that's why I have Hidden Power Ice to take care of that, just in case try switching it in. And that has a Choice Scarf on it to give it a very good speed. It seems like around 360, if I believe, with a Choice Scarf. Don't quote me on it, but I think that's what it is. Now for my hazard setter, I have Pineco. It is a max special attack, 228 defense, and 28 special defense, relaxed nature. It has zero speed IVs because I have Gyro Ball on it to try to do some damage because, Pineco can't really do much and might as well have something. It has Sturdy ability to make sure it can at least get off one Stealth Rock. But it has Stealth Rock, Spikes, Rapid Spin, and Gyro Ball. Basically, kind of like the common set for Fortress, just taken down and given to Pineco. I gave it an Inviolite to try to boost his defenses, and it's around 500 with the Inviolite. It's pretty darn high, and it can truck really any type of fighting type moves all day. Pineco kind of serves as my physical wall without recovery, which is kind of, it's a give and take. It's really bulky, but no recovery. My next Pokemon is Hypno, and Hypno is the special wall of the team. It is max hit points, HP, and max special defense with 4 defense EVs. It is a calm nature to maximize it to 361 special defense. It has the ability Insomnia to try to, a Executor Sleep Powder, any try to Sleep Powder Hypnosis trying to aim at my team, I can switch them in effectively. Its movesets is kind of not really original. It's Wish, Protect, Toxic, and Seismic Toss. Basically the Wish Pass-Through of the team, plus Toxic and Seismic Toss to do some damage. It has leftovers on it to get some more HP whenever it's not wishing. And here is where I kind of was a little bit more creative with the team, because Beartick is a Pokemon that I've never ever seen used in Mew, and I thought, I really want to use this Pokemon for a team. So what I did was I ran a little bit of a different set because I really hate that the Dream World ability hasn't been released yet, the Swift Swim, because I really want that ability, because that would make it so much better. But until then, I have a 172 HP, 252 attack, and 84 speed, and his Adamant Nature, bring it to about 350 attack. And this is a sub-punch set, so Substitute, Focus Punch, Icicle Crash, and Night Slash. And the reason why I picked Icicle Crash, Stab, Focus Punch, because, people don't really expect a Focus Punching Beartick, which is kind of element of surprise, even though it is a set in Smogon. It is pretty effective. And the Night Slash, it deals any psychic types trying to switch into the Focus Punch. And that has leftovers on it because I decided that Beretic needed the leftovers instead of a life orb, because it already hits hard enough already and just needs some recovery. And then Tauros is my fifth Pokemon, another physical attacker. It is max attack, max speed with Jolly Nature. That's 350 speed for it. It has Sheer Force ability with the life orb to, you know, maximize all of these secondary effects without taking much damage. I have Rock Climb on it for an effective stab. Zen Headbutt to counter any fighting types that bring brought in. Rock Slide to counter any, fire, flying, and Earthquake. And I had Kevin do the calculations for me, and it turns out Earthquake does more damage than the Bulldoze, so I decided to put that in there anyway. But I really like this Tauros set because it's so fast and it hits so hard that I really think if you need a normal type that can do to any attacking role, you need a Tauros. And my sixth Pokemon is a little cut Pokemon, Clamperl. And it has the ability Rattled, which it raises speed one stage when it's hit by a Dark, Ghost, or Bug type move, which is kind of nice when it hits a Sucker Punch, even though I can't really live one, but oh well. But this is a really cool little cut Pokemon. I think it should definitely be in new. I personally think it's better than Gorbis, but you know, people are kind of conflicted about this. But I really, really love Clamperl because it a Shell Smash set with max special attack and max speed with a Timid Nature. It has Shell Smash, Surf for an effective stab, Ice Beam, and Hidden Power Grass. And it hits so hard. I can't even explain to you. Because when I give the Deep Sea Tooth, it doubles the special attack. And after a Shell Smash, Clamperl's hitting about 900 special attack. That's 200 more than a Gorbis for like a slight speed decrease, which I think is totally worth it. And so that concludes my team today. I really hope you guys liked it. Please make sure to like it or give me any type of recommendations for what type of, what I can improve on, what can I make a team for, anything you guys want to throw at me, I would very appreciate it. And make sure to thank K-Dubs for letting me be on his channel for doing this. And make sure to tell him to keep up the good work too and use my teams as much as you can. Well, thank you guys. I hope you enjoy it.